By the time Ojar Ogwal joined Omoti Primary School in Gulu, the school had 415 learners, of which 215 were girls and 200 were boys. Ogwal adds that the school was only registering passes and passing in first grade, but the learners were not an issue.
Community never had a proper impression of the school. As you know, people were looking at it at the government school, you get there, you never make it. The biggest challenge was the mindset of our staffs. People were taking work for granted. I realized the school performance and was being undermined because of the lack of the effort from the teachers. Then we started building from that point. By the time I came here, the school was not registering passes. Passing in first grade wasn't the issue. And now as we talk, we are now 800 plus learners.
Ogwal explains that in Omoti Primary School, girls perform better than boys.
In this school, girls are more than the boys. Come back to performance, girls also are performing better than boys. Taking an example, last year we had 8 first graders. Out of the 8 first graders, 5 were girls. Luckily enough, we got the best performed girl in the government school came from our school here.
He adds that they have created learning centers at homes of children with disabilities where they give lessons to learners every weekend.
Weekend, Saturdays, we get to their home, like 2 hours engagement, and then the children from the nearby family there, they come there and they learn, children in the school. Last year, one of the child passed in Division 1 and it was a child with disability. So we have now put the school to be the home and the home to be the school.
When it comes to working on different projects at the school, Ogwal says he engages parents and they gladly volunteer. Due to this initiative, students can now have lunch at school.
We identify, say, parents, you have different talents. And out of these different talents, these are what we want to make. And then we make the teachers to come up with the design of the learning aids that they want. Those parents who are talented in that, we call them. Voluntarily, they come and help. So that we make our school decorate, learning to be really and everything active. Every Friday, parents come to work in the school. So they produce the crop. When they produce the crop, we feed the children. And as a result, you can even now see P1, P2, what do Tor takes them home? There's nothing, they're just in the school, and everybody's enjoying the school.
Well, in P1, we used not to eat lunch from school. We just go up to home and we come back. But the teacher delay in the class, we cannot now go back for lunch. Lunch is now, we can eat it from school.
As teachers, Ogwal says they have started their own saving circle at the school.
Saving, as a staff, the circles, staff circles, teachers now no longer comes to me. They borrow money from within the pool, and they pay with little interest, the interest of 2%. And that's how we are helping ourselves. You know, it's very easy to manage someone who is economically stable. We do not have the staff room. We do not have the library. We have created our staff room, our library in the classroom. We are doing what we call co-teaching.
Omoti Primary School now has 3 classroom blocks and students are able to use computers.
When I joined this school, it was not nice as it is now. Things have now changed and we have computers. Everything is at school.
The computers are very nice because the words which you don't know is just like a dictionary. You can just find it from the computer. That is why I like.
Teachers Making a Difference is part of Uganda Making a Difference project implemented by New Vision since 2008. The project targets teachers in public primary and secondary schools across the country.